So good morning everyone. We start with the lab for week 5. Now in this lab we will do the exercise for both the concepts that we have learned in this week, which is interface and inner classes. First of all, we will start our lab with the interface. The first question is solved for you. From the second question I will start doing it. The first question is a demo question. So it is based on the concept of one interface in one class. That means we create an interface and implement that interface in a class. Let's first of all understand the question and then we will check how it is solved, and then I will start solving the rest of the questions. Alright, so write a Java interface, namely calculator, and it has three methods: add, subtract, multiply. The return type of all these three methods is double, and all the three methods take two parameters. So let's check how to make the interface. As we know, we need to use the keyword interface, so public class interface. And we will add three methods. Without the implementation, the methods will end with the semicolon. So this is how we make our interface. Next is implement the interface into the class sample, then write a driver class to create the object of the sample class, and invoke the methods of the class with the proper inputs. So we create a class sample, we implement the class calculator over here in the interface calculator over here. And in the interface, we have three methods. Now we must provide the implementation to these three methods. So because they have a return type, so we have provided here for the add, we are adding two numbers, multiply, we are multiplying two numbers, and in subtraction, we are subtracting. Then we have the main class. In the main class, we have made the object of the concrete class, class sample, and then we have called the methods with the appropriate input. So this was one interface and one class. So that means we have defined one interface and we have implemented in one class. Now let's go ahead, write a Java interface, namely calculator, and it has same three methods. So what will I do? I will create an interface. Let's start creating it. Empty Java file. Okay, let me just select the path where I want to make it. Alright, so we make it over here, calculator. Okay, so calculator, it's multiple interface, and it's the same interface. I can see from here what I will do. I will copy this code. Alright, so I will just copy it over here. And let's compile it because it's the same interface which we created in the first class. Next is create another Java interface, namely circle, and it has the following two methods, area and circumference. Alright, so we create another interface which is circle, and it has two methods, circle area, and it takes two parameters, I think, double radius, only one parameter, double radius, both of them take only one parameter. So I will just write here double radius, and I have a method here circumference, and it also takes one parameter, which is radius. I remove the last line. Let's compile it. Alright, done. Now what we have to do, we have to create a class sample, and in this we have to implement two interfaces. That means we are going to do now multiple inheritance. So I'll create a class sample. Sample. Let's start public class sample implements calculator comma circle. Now since this class implements both the interfaces, I must provide an implementation to the method. So let me provide the implementation to the methods of the class calculator. I'll just write over here Instead, what I can do, I can copy the implementation of the methods from over here because it's the same. So instead of writing it, I'll copy it from here, from the example which is provided. Now I have to provide the implementation to the methods of the class circle also, because my sample class implements the interface circle also. Alright, so I will remove this semicolon and I will provide an area. Area is pi r square. Return 3.14 multiplied by radius multiplied by radius, and circumference is calculated as 2 pi r. Return 2 multiplied by 3.14 multiplied by radius. Let's compile it. Done. Alright, now we have to create a class driver, test class. So instead of driver, I will make the class with the name of the question. So since this is question number 1, so I will make it test 1. Main class, test 1. So we will create an object of the sample class here. Sample S1 is equals to new sample. Now I need to call all the methods. I can copy the code for calling the methods for addition, subtraction and multiplication from here. And then I have to call the radius and the circumference also. So I have to give only one parameter. Area of circle is so S dot area. And I will pass a parameter 2 over here, and same thing over here, circumference. Circumference S dot circumference. I'll pass the same parameter 2 or 1 maybe. Let's compile it. Okay, let's check the errors. Because I removed the code above, that's why. So public class test 1, that's why I have the error here, because by mistake I removed all the code above. Alright, so I have because S1S. So it's done. Let's check it. So addition, subtraction, area and circumference. So this was example of multiple inheritance using interfaces. Let's proceed to the next example, next question. Now, abstract class implementing more than interface. Now, in all these questions which are given in your exercise, we are just creating one interface. So, I am not going to create the interface again and again. Rather, I will use the interface which I have already created. So, that's the purpose of the interface. You create only once and you use it across many classes. Alright, so I have to create the interface calculator, which I already have. I already created in program number 1. I'm not going to create it. Another interface circle, I already created it. I'm not going to create it again. Now, I have to implement two interfaces into the abstract class sample. Now, I have to create the abstract class sample. So I'm not going to name it as sample, rather I will name it as sample 2, else it will give me a naming error. So let me just create an abstract class. Sample 2, why sample 2? Because it belongs the it's question number 2, so that you can know it. Okay, so public abstract class sample 2 implements. So what I have to do, I have to implement the two interfaces. I have to make the abstract class to be implemented from the two interfaces, calculator and circle. I repeat it again, what we are doing in this question, we are creating an abstract class, and the abstract class implements the two interfaces, calculator and circle. All right, now in this abstract class, implement the methods of calculator only. So I'm not going to implement the methods of circle class, rather only the calculator interface. So this is possible, I can do it. So the calculator class has three methods, add, multiply and subtract. I will do it, I will just implement them. So let's compile it. This is what we are required to do it. An abstract class can contain abstract methods as well as non-abstract methods. So I don't have any abstract methods, but I made the class as an abstract because it implements the class circle, and the circle class has abstract methods. That's why I made this class as abstract. Now what we are doing, we are going to create a class demo. Now it extends from the abstract class. So let's create a class demo. Demo, public class demo. Now understand the hierarchy. Extends sample 2. So sample 2 implements calculator and circle interface. So that means they are the parents for sample 2. Now demo extends from abstract class sample 2. That means sample 2 is the direct parent, but still calculator and circle methods will be inherited by demo because they are the super parents or the indirect parents. Since in the abstract class we implemented only the methods of the calculator interface, and demo also in indirect way inherits from the circle interface, we have to implement the methods of the circle interface in this class, otherwise we will get an error. So in the demo class, in this concrete class, implements the method of the circle interface. So I will just implement the methods of the circle interface. I will copy this code. No need to write this code again and again. So let's just compile it. Done. Now we will create a driver class or the test class. I will name it as test 2 so that you can know it, that it belongs to the question number 2. And then we are going to create an object for the concrete class and invoke all the methods of the abstract class, which is the sample class, and the demo class. So let's create the main class now. Test 2, because it belongs to the question number 2. So let me just remove this. So what will I do? I will create an object of the test 2. So I will create an object of the concrete class, not the object of the abstract class. So I will create an object of the demo class over here. Demo d1 is equals to new demo, and I will call all the methods. So I will call all these methods. Although add, subtract and multiply methods, they are implemented in the sample 2 class, which was the abstract class. area and circumference methods. We provided the implementation in the concrete class, which was the demo class, but we are printing everything, calling all the method and printing all the information over here. Sorry, it was D1. Let me just make it like this. All right, so let's run it. That's the beauty of the interface. You just create once, use it across many times. So again, the concept of inheritance, reusability. All right, we move on to the next question, which is the third question. Extending an interface. Now, I will create an interface calculator. I will create another interface calc, which extends from calculator. So I have a calculator. Let me just make it calculator 1 so that you have no confusions. Calculator 1. Calculator 1. All right, I'll create an interface calculator 1. Calculator 1. Now, what do I have to do? In this interface, I have to include only two methods, add and subtract. So I can copy these two methods from the calculator interface. No need to write it again and again. So this is calculator 1. I can remove this method, multiply. All right. Now what we need to do? We need to create another Java interface. Now this Java interface is derived from calculator 1. In the previous questions, when we have made the interface, they are independent interface, they are standalone. But now an interface is inheriting from another interface. So let's create another interface. The name is calc. So now we are not going to use the word implements, it will be keyword extends. Public interface calc extends calculator 1. So that means calc has both the methods from the calculator 1, and we need to provide only one method over here, which is multiplication. So I have interface calculator 1, which has two methods, add and subtract. I have calc interface, which extends from calculator 1 interface, and it has only one method, which is multiply. Let's go back to the question. Write a concrete class sample. Now this should implement only the calc interface, not the calculator 1. It says over here. But we will check, we will get an error. Now I will explain you later on what's the error. So it implements the calc interface. Alright, I'm not going to make it as a name as its sample. It will be named as sample 3 because it's for question number 3. Sample 3. Public class sample 3. Implements calc. Now we are inheriting our class from calc interface, but calc is derived from calculator. So that means indirectly I have to provide the implementation of the methods which are derived in the calculator 1 interface and also which are defined in the calc interface, because sample 3 class is indirectly inheriting from the calculator 1, because we are implementing calc and calc extends from calculator 1. That's why. Implements, keyword is implements. So I will provide the implementation to all these three methods. The reason I told you just now. If I don't provide it, all right. Let's just do it this way. Alright, calc has only one interface, one method, multiply. Let me just provide a implementation to the method multiply only. Let's check. Because according to the question, if I go to the question, it says implement interface calc, right? Interface calc has only one method, multiply. So that means I must provide an implementation to the multiply method, but it will give me an error. Why? Because calc extends from calculator. That means calc inherits all the methods of the calculator one. So indirectly I have to provide the implementation or to the methods of the calculator one interface also. That's why I am getting a error over here. So I will just copy this code. I'll copy this code also, subtract. Now let's compile it. I won't get any error. Yeah. Alright, now write a driver class for the concrete class. Our concrete class is sample3 and invoke all the methods as usual. So I'll write the test3 class, test3. And I will provide the implementation to all the methods over here. Alright, so I just put the code here, sample3, that's it. Let me, I don't have area and circumference method. I need to remove these methods. So only add, subtract and multiply. Please read the question carefully. The question has all the hints. So we are done with the question number 3. Last question is multiple inheritance through interfaces. So we are going to create one interface calculator, another interface circle. We already have created it. We are going to create an abstract class sample and with the following method, void print. So we are going to create an abstract class. The class is sample. We are not inheriting this class sample from any of the interface, just like a simple abstract class, not inheriting from any of the thing. Alright, so let's create an abstract class and I will name it as sample4, because this belongs to the question number 4. Alright, so public abstract class sample4. Alright, so with the following method, void print. So since it's an abstract class, I will make this method as abstract, public abstract void print. Let's compile it. It has only one method. Alright. So now what do I have in this question? I have a calculator interface which I have defined in the question 1. I have a circle interface which I have defined in the question 1. I am going to use the same interface. Now I have a class abstract class. It has one abstract method which is the print method. Now let's create a class, demo class, which is my concrete class, and it extends from the abstract class and it implements the two interfaces. So we are going to use the multiple inheritance. That means it is inheriting from the class also, as well as it is implementing the interfaces also. So I will name the class as demo4. Demo4, public class demo4 extends sample4, implements calculator circle. So this is an example of the multiple inheritance. My class demo is inheriting from another abstract class sample4 and two interfaces which is calculator and the circle. So this is a true example of the multiple inheritance. Now I have to provide the implementation to all the methods. So what will I do? Add, multiply, subtract, area, circumference, these belong to the interfaces. So I am going to copy the code. And sample 4 class only has a method print. Now what this method should do? Let's look at the question. I will remove the keyword abstract from here while implementing and remove this semicolon. Let's check what this method should do from the question. Okay. Write a driver class to create and invoke all the methods of the abstract class. Alright, it is not saying anything what should be done to print it. Alright, what we can do, we can just call the methods because it's not mentioned over here. Let's read it again. Following method void print. Okay, demo that extends abstract class sample and implements the two interfaces. But we have to implement this abstract class method also, which is hidden inside, which is not written clearly. So that means you have to sometimes make sense out of or by yourself, right? Sometimes it won't be clearly mentioned in the question. In the driver class, we will create an object of the concrete class and invoke all the methods of the abstract class and concrete class with proper interfaces. Alright, so we need to invoke all the methods of the... Okay, it doesn't say over here abstract. So let me remove the word abstract over here. We can provide an implementation to the print method over here also. Void print. Since it's not mentioned over here, okay, system.out.println, let me just write this is an abstract class because it's not mentioned that it should be an abstract method. So let's do not make it as an abstract method. All right, done. So now let's make a test class. I'll call it as test 4. So I'll make an object of demo 4. Demo 4 d1 is equals to d is equals to new demo 4. You can use the scanner class also. Alright, so I'll print all these methods and I'll call the abstract class method also. Abstract class method, I don't need to write the system.print statement, so I will just write d.print. That was a print method, I guess. Yes, it was a print method. So our program compiled successfully. Alright, so we called all the methods of the abstract class. So that was all about the interfaces. You can practice all these questions. Now I will start with the exercise for the inner class. Two or three simple questions we are going to create for the inner class. So let's start with the inner class questions. Alright. So we will read the question line by line. Create a class outer class. Alright. So let me just give it a name. The name of the file will always be the outer class. Outer class, public class, outer class. Now let's check what we have to do. Declare a private instance variable. The name of the variable is name and type is string. And then create a constructor with parameter. All right, so private string name, and I have to make a constructor, public outer class string name, this dot name is equals to name. All right, now let's check what we have to do next. Create a method outer class print and print the value of the instance variable. All right, so we create a method public void outer class print, and we just print over here system.out.println. I just print here the instance variable of the outer class is plus name. I'm just going to print the instance variable of the outer class. Create another method access inner class. Okay, we will do it later because it's a method of inner class and we have to make the object of inner class. Let's skip this point. We go to the next point. Create an inner class which is called as inner class. Let's create another class over here. We must make sure that we have to make a class inside the class. Let's make it as private, although it's not mentioned, private inner class. Alright, create a method print inner class and I will print the value of the instance variable of the outer class because it does not have any variable. So public void and the name of the method is, let's check, print inner class. Alright, print inner class and system.out.println. Accessing the outer class variable from inner class. So I'm going to access the outer class variable from inner class. I can access it because doesn't matter over here whether public or private. All right, now what I have to do, this is for the test class. I have create another method access inner class. Now this method should be made in the outer class. So my inner class ends here. I'll make a method over here, public void. Let me copy the method access inner class. Now what this method should do, this method should make the object of inner class and call the inner class method. Alright, now we have to create the inner class object and call the inner class method. Simple, name of the class inner class in is equals to new inner class and I'll call the inner class method in dot print inner class. Let's compile it. I must have a print inner class because I made the I capital. Let's compile it again. Print inner class. Okay. m dot print inner class. Alright, let me just, yeah, c was also small here. Done. Now what we need to do, we need to create a test class, make the object of the outer class and call the method access inner class, which is the inner class method. Alright, so I make a main class, I call it as test outer. Alright, so let's just create it. We create outer class out is equals to new outer class. Now we have made over here a parameterized constructor and it takes one string parameter. Let me just write something, Java programming. Alright, now what I, which method I have to call? I have to call access inner class. Access inner class is the one where we have made the object of the inner class and we call the inner class method. Alright, alright, so out dot. Let's check it. Alright, accessing the outer class variable from the inner class. I can call the outer class method also. So out dot, what was the name of the outer class method? Outer class print. I can call because this belongs to the outer class, so it won't be a problem. Outer class. So this method we can, sorry, I forgot over here. So in this method we are accessing the outer class variable from inner class and this is the instance variable of the outer class. So if you see over here, I made the inner class as public, then I created the method where I made the object of the inner class and called the inner class method over here, and in the main class I just created an object of the outer class and called the method. Alright, so let's move to the another question. Create an outer class, class out. So we create an outer class, class out, public class, class out. Alright, now what we need to do here is declare and initialize an instance variable int data. We need to initialize also. So int data is equals to 10 maybe. Now what we need to do, let's check, create a method print. This will invoke the inner class method also. Alright, so we just skip the point number, this point for a while. Create an inner class, class in. Let's create an inner class first of all. It does not have any constructor. Public class, class in. Now what it should have, declare and initialize an instance variable data to. Alright, so let's initialize int data to is equals to 5 maybe. Alright, create a method print and print the values of variables of class out and class in. All right, let's do it. All right, so quite simple. So the name of the method is print. Public void print and system.out.println. Inner class variable plus data 2 and outer class variable. Outer class variable data. I will do one thing more at the end of this. Sorry, it will not compile because we haven't finished it yet. We need to have something more for this. Okay, so print. Now we need to create a method print also. This will invoke the inner class method print and print the values of the instance variables of class out and class in. Okay, so we have a outer class method also, a print, and it will invoke the inner class method. All right, so my class ends here. So what we need to do here is create a method print. This will invoke the inner class method print to print the values of instance variable class out and class in. All right, so let's create a method over here outside the outer class, inner class. Public void print. So I can simply write it as print. It will call the inner class method. Or I think I can ignore this statement. Because of this, I think I'm not going to do it over here. Let's go to the main class first, because let's do it from the main class. That will be a better way. Alright, let's go to the program. Alright, so accessing data from the outer class. Okay, so you should have output is given over here. Make an object of class out and print the instance variables of class out and class in. Okay, the basically the purpose is to call the print methods from outer class and from the inner class. So let's create the main class. Let's call it as test out. Test out. So we will try to call the methods of the inner class and the outer class from here. All right. Let's create an object of the outer class as usual, class out. Let's compile our previous class. Let's check it compiles. I will not make the print method here. Rather, I will call from here the inner class print method. All right, class out. Out is equals to new class out. As usual, we make the outer class object. Now, since I have to call the inner class method, I will call from here, not from there. So what will I do? I will create an inner class object. In the main class, my purpose is to show you how you can create an object of the outer class in the main class, because my inner class is actually a public class. So I can create an object. We discussed in the slides also, if your inner class is public, class name of the outer class dot name of the inner class, class in followed by inner class object name, whatever you want to give, is equals to outer class object dot new name of the inner class. This is how you can make an object for the public inner class outside the outer class. All right, so system dot out dot println. Let me just try to call the variables from over here. Accessing the instance variable of outer class, which is data, and accessing the instance variable of inner class. Now this is, we are accessing the variables in the main method plus data too. And I can call the inner class method also with the help of object dot print. So I am calling the inner class method. I am printing the value of the instance variables in the test class. Let's compile it. What's data and data 2? Let's just check it. Okay, my class out. Okay, let's check the error. I must use the name of the object out.data, and for the inner class, name of the variable in1.data. So just like the rules we have to follow, it's done. All right, so let's compile it. So I can access from both the classes. Alright, now an important concept which we have discussed in the slides also. For example, if both of them, they have the same name, then what should happen? If it is also data and this is also data, then I should write here, if outer class variable and the inner class variable, they have the same name. So what should I write here? This dot data. This will refer to the inner class data, and here I need to write here inner outer class name, class out dot variable. Sorry, I forgot over here this keyword, this dot data. So if both outer class and inner class, they have the same variable name, so using this dot data will print the inner class variable value, and name of the class dot this dot data will print the outer class variable value. And if I go over here, I just have to write over here the name of the object and name of the variable. So let's just check it. So this is how you can use the this keyword also. with the inner classes. So I get the same output over here. So let's go here. All right, we have finished with the questions for the inner class also. So all your questions will be answered in the live class. So thank you so much.